Come on.
Pack it up, pack it in. Let me begin. Let me begin. Let me begin.
That's no moon. It's a space station.
This is madness.
A long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
What's going on? I wasn't sure if I was supposed to do the intro or not, because it's been 3 weeks, and hey! Welcome back to another Shootin the Poodoo. I have been on an excruciating three-week training course, and I'm so happy to be here. I'm so happy to be back. I'm back with my crew. What is up, everybody? Chris, Mike, yeah! Mark, Claire, let's go!
I'm glad you're back from your bank heist.
Oh, my God.
I hope it went well.
That's right. It was a Ocean's 11 type situation. I was actually in England trying to steal the jewels at Buckingham Palace.
Dang.
Great.
I mean, it seems like the royal family's got a lot going on right now. They might be a little distracted.
Oh, I know. That's why it was the perfect time.
Perfect timing for your eyes.
What do you think happened to Kate Middleton?
Well, we know now.
Soderbergh was there. It was great. Clooney.
Holy moly. I miss
you
guys.
Yes, sir. Yeah, man. Welcome back, dude. Yeah.
And hi, Chris.
Hi.
Chris is here. Chris is back.
This is really exciting.
Yeah, we got trailers to talk about. Chris is here.
It's an exciting day.
X-Men 97.
Form like Voltron.
Yeah.
Oh, man. What? So we did like one show while I was gone, right? Like you guys at least did one or two.
Yeah, I completely shut down. I mean, there's just been so much going on too that it was not even possible.
It was rough.
It was a trip.
I was in Texas. I was alone. I made some friends, but I was completely shut out. Like just shut down. I wasn't on socials. Nothing. I was like, I just want to go back to my room, drink, fall asleep, and go. And get these 3 weeks over so I go home and see my family. I was so depressed, dude. And I got home yesterday, landed at 10:35. And it was cool. I was so depressed that I was like, the company bought my tickets and I'm looking and first class was like $130 to upgrade. And I was like, I'm fucking doing it.
Treat yourself.
I did it. And it was the first time I ever did this. I felt so like I should have been wearing a monocle.
Okay, bougie.
A top hat.
Yeah.
And being, dude, it was pretty nice. They gave me an enchilada while I was sitting there. And it was a breakfast.
Airline enchilada.
Breakfast enchilada.
It was pretty good. That'll never happen again, but
sure.
So I'm not lasting.
It's a good way to come back.
Yeah. Except when we do, it was Philly. It was a bad rain on Saturday.
Yes, it was. It's very bad.
And, bro, I couldn't see out the window. And, like, dude, the plane was not fun those last, like, 10 minutes.
Damn, bro.
Fucking thing was dipping and, like, shaking. And I'm like, I'm going to die.
We had a whole comedy safely.
And it was great. I was expecting there to be like some blow up pilot happen, you know, like airplane.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Julie Haggerty.
I was thinking the same thing.
But no, I am.
Welcome back.
I'm so happy to be back, man.
I bet. I
can't wait to get back. Like we're back with this.
exciting stuff.
The Last of Us Part 2 is going to be happening.
Okay, all right.
Oh, I'm ready. I'm ready. I was depressed. Okay. I could just jump right back in.
You
it,
were
okay?
depressed?
Well, we got more of that for you, my friend.
Yeah. Keep that right here in your heart.
I can change mental states like underwear.
Oh, all right. You're going to be changing some underwear soon as well. Just keep a lot of underwear. Hold it in your hand. Just hold it in your hand.
How's everybody else been?
Good. You know.
Yeah. Up, hanging. Down. Just a lot of everything.
Yep.
People in Texas can't drive. That's what I found
Well, they
out.
Can't drive here in California, especially when it rains. So.
I don't think people can drive.
I mean, this dude, one of these guys in my class got T-boned in the parking lot of a Quick Trip, which is like a technic. It's like kind of like a quick stop. I don't fucking
know.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I've never heard of them. And just T-boned by trying to park.
You know, when you're trying to get out of the parking lot and you get T-boned, now that makes for a Quick Trip.
No, it was a Quick Trip.
Thank you, Claire.
Yeah.
I'm waiting to see if I get booted.
Thank you, Claire.
That's right. Chris is back. You better watch out. The boot button is there.
Exactly.
I love you, Chris. Please don't boot me.
One good thing that happened while I was out there was I had no idea it was coming. And the Acolyte trailer dropped.
Yeah, dude.
Bro.
Birthday to me.
Bro. I was, let's get ready for some new era Star Wars. Am I fucking right?
Good, man.
Yeah. No, man, it looks great. It looks great. It's cool.
There's so many lightsabers, dude.
Yeah,
I know. I saw yellow pop up everywhere. I'm like, holy shit.
I was like,
if I see some cross guard action, I'm just going to be like, I got it. Yeah.
It was only one person in the High Republic that has a cross guard lightsaber, if I remember correctly, and they're not in this show. Yeah. It's only Vernestra Rowe is. And I'm literally talking about my ass because I only know a little bit about the High Republic, but I know that much.
You know, I got through the first stage of the High Republic and a little bit of the second and kind of fell off, but I'm excited to see like this. I've been waiting for new era Star Wars to pop up on the screen, and this is what I'm talking about. I want something fresh. Yeah. Like when The Mandalorian came out, it was like basically this new, not like a new era, but it was a new time period that we haven't been, you know, involved in. Mm-hmm. So it was just really cool to see all the players at first, and then we started seeing all these people from what we remember. But this, I mean, the only other person I think that we're Yoda, besides everybody that we know from the books and shit, right?
Yeah,
like Yoda.
And possibly,
oh,
Yariel Poof will be there. Opal Rancisis will be there.
Yeah.
There was a Wookiee Jedi before this Kelnaka one that's in the show named Buriaga.
Buriaga.
Yeah, Buriaga.
And
I know Buriaga.
He's not in this show. He's not making out of this. Yeah, things are not looking good then. Because, I mean, nothing looks good in the High Republic. Everything's horrible.
Yeah, so
everything's horrible.
Yeah, I had to take a break for a bit because every novel that I read ended in mass genocide. And I was shit. Well, let me take a walk and
into a planet. Stellan Geos dies.
Yeah. All of them just know how to ruin days, man. Like, even the more lighthearted ones, that Daniel Jose Oda does. I'm like, well, I walk away and he's like, ugh.
Are we okay, High Republic writing fam? Are we okay?
Hey, so the one thing that I enjoyed about the High Republic is that they can do wild shit to make the stories way more intense because people don't, I hate to use the word or the phrase canon armor, but like they could just get you to love someone and kill the shit.
Chris what I is just dying. Over Red Tornado calling Oppo Rancis's Harris.
Oh.
Yep.
I love Star Wars. I love Star Wars because you say Harry Snake Man. We all know who you're talking about.
Oh, I don't, but sure.
I'll send you a picture, Mark.
The only thing I can think of is like when you guys are talking about like how every story kind of ends kind of like sad or like really, really, you know, shocking. It sounds like Elliot Reed from Scrubs should be telling each story because every time she gets to the end of a story, somebody either kills herself or something. Yeah.
I just never saw his body. Oh, God. He is a snake. I just only ever remember seeing the top part.
I was just laughing at the words Harry Snake Man. I'm sorry.
Harry Snake Man.
Stop it.
Harry Snake Man has been dropped in the Broaxium group chat. You're welcome.
Harry Snake
Man.
Said it. So, she's saying it so casually. It's just
But
in Oppo we trust.
Oh, this kid's just getting the scene.
So Chris,
yeah, man.
When is the Acolyte taking place amongst like the books and the comics and stuff like that?
Oh.
Thank you, buddy. Push him up. That's when I got to ask Mike a Marvel question.
It's 100 years before Phantom Menace.
Nice. Chris Assault, to me, my Brax Man.
Shirts! Oh my God! Shirts! Our arrows can blot out the sun.
Every time Mark hits a banger, just Q300 and Michael Fassbender goes, "We'll fight in the shade." Like, that's literally what it is.
I don't want to boot up Photoshop while this is going on. This is going to ruin the browser. I'll wait.
Mark is crushing.
Please write that down.
Notes.
Please write that down. God, I miss Chris and stuff like this.
That still needs to be a shirt. I'm sorry. Yeah. Context.
Or just Bart Privilege on
Bart
it as well.
Privilege in a shirt.
It is Bart Privilege.
My goodness.
That man is a wonder.
Look at him. Amazing credit.
Just you couldn't have
fantastic credit. Just walk so in, good. Buys the car. Just buys it.
Yeah.
Credit check passes.
No.
He's the guy that spends the whole money on the new phone. You just pay it all off.
Oh my God.
Awesome.
I want my bill to be low.
Down payment? No, not for you, buddy. Not for you.
Now you're down payment, more like downgraded charging.
Yeah.
White.
just ends it with the white. Chris has been back for 13 minutes and we're nearly broke him.
I haven't been more happy in my life. I was very happy.
This is what you get for leaving, Dan. And this is what you get.
This is a cherry on top. Yeah, being here doing this.
Everybody gets a piece of the monkey bread.
So we're 100 years before the Phantom Menace.
Yep.
I mean, is this going to set anything up? Do we think this is going to set some shit up to lead into?
It's like, a good question.
I know it's 100 years, but I mean,
I have no idea.
We know that Palps, well, he's not alive, but I mean, we had his other dude.
If we think
the other guy. Yeah, the plan. Right.
Plan could still be like, you know, in play. Like, you know, who knows if, you know, if Plagueis is around or is this even the Sith? This could be some other Darksider that has that red saber that you see. It doesn't even have to be Plagueis.
Yeah.
But
what's that species? The immune or something like that?
Immune.
Yeah. So how long do they live? I never.
I don't know because they're immune to a lot of diseases. I'm sorry.
No, I'm here for it.
He's just asking.
Because I was thinking of a bit.
I did it. Sorry, Chris. I love you very much.
That shit was like a rapid punch.
I think they live a long time.
We're back, baby.
I think they do.
It would make sense for this to, you know, they like to tie everything together,
weave
those stories. And I'm excited. I mean, it looks really good. Yeah. I just production value looks awesome. And they should, because look, after Ahsoka, like, you need to just keep the gas on the floor.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
Put the gas on the floor.
Don't let it match. I feel like that's a fire hazard. Watch this. Putting the gas though. On the floor.
Gas pedal?
There we go. Pedal to the metal.
Yeah, pedal to the metal.
Don't breathe in too deep.
Yeah, I meant driving.
Don't breathe in too deep. You will get sick.
Yeah. But
make sure you wash that off.
But I don't think that we're going to hit. Well, I think that if we do start to approach that territory, what I've heard is that they're trying to set this up for a multi-season run. It's not just like a limited one and done. So I think we're going to take some time before we'd hit that point. But it'd be cool if we hit that point by the end of this series, wherever, however they designed to do that.
And then, like, one of the cool things is, like, think of the era that we're in right now as far as, like, the Mandalorian era. That's only, you know, that's 7 years, 10 years out from at least right now, like, where they're out from Return of the Jedi. To get to Force Awakens, you still got another 22 years to go.
Yeah.
So there's so many epic things that can happen, you know, with the galaxy in 100 years time. Because Palpatine, I don't think he isn't born until, I think, like, I think he's 48 or maybe 50 in Phantom Menace.
This is why I wish I had sometimes Brian here to cherry. He's the Palpatine guy. Yeah. He would know. But but we're that's what we're getting right now in the old Bad Batch. Stuff like that. This cloning shit is out of control.
Yeah.
So I can't wait to see where this is going. Oh, I got to watch the Bad Batch while I was in Texas. Jesus.
Chris, Chris, how many episodes do we have left?
We have seven or eight.
I didn't know they could make it like that. I watched it I didn't watch the new trailer yet. I have to still watch that. But when it ended, I was like, that's it? Like, why are we only getting half a season? But I was so sad. Like, I was so sad watching the Bad Batch. Just, I mean, it was a heartwarming ending there. Like, the Omega gets back with the boys. She's grown up. And just like watching her, at that facility with her big sister, who's just so freaking mind fucked by that evil cloning bastard. Oh my God. They made that guy scary.
Hemlock.
That guy creeped that. Yeah. Hemlock.
And if you think he's psycho. Such a good performance in that, then I remember he's a McPoyle and then I laugh mid spooky monologue.
Is he really? He's one of the McPoyle.
Yes.
From Sunny.
He's the one that's also in Westworld. Yes, he's a
McPoyle. I love him. That's I didn't know him. That was the voice actor.
That's him. You're going to hear it now. And then you're going to think about drinking milk in their open robes with no shirts.
One eyebrow. So. Una. Oh, my God.
You'll hear it now.
But I love that dude's a good actor. I think he's got he's a good voice, too. So I'm happy about that.
And he's spooky.
He really did make that shit spooky. But yeah, the Acolyte, we got just like a tease. That was a tease. That spooky. Like that spooky. Acolyte trailer was just like, I need more. Give me something.
That Acolyte trailer was also spooky.
Star Wars fans did what they did best while they're just taking one single shot and like, this is what's going to happen. And I'm like,
that was very Akbar of you.
Very good, Dan.
It was very Admiral Akbar.
So glad you're back, picture. Man.
But yeah, I mean, it's. We don't know. Nobody knows. Nope. Nobody knows.
Kurt Angle knows.
Oh, he does. Oh, God.
Yes.
But it does look amazing. I'm
great.
Super excited. Like, I've just been really excited to see something that's like way off the time frame.
Yeah.
Like
that
new Jedi Order movie that's going to be coming out at some point, like the beginning of it all. That I'm like so pumped up for that too. I just want something just outside of what we know.
Yeah. No, absolutely. I'm ready.
The High Republic looks exciting.
Outside of what we
know.
I can't wait to go in blind.
On a Star Wars.
Exactly. I mean, that's like I said, that's what made exciting. The Mandalorian, the first season of The Mandalorian, so friggin' awesome. Mm-hmm. Was just what's going on here. But speaking of franchises,
Segway,
Romulus.
Also, speaking of spooky,
we're going back to the spooky. Spooky.
Oh, it looks so good.
The face huggers look a lot like the face huggers, the music, the sound effects
in the background. I mean, it's just, it's got all of that, the claustrophobic feeling, the dark corridors, like everything.
I've already got the nightmares.
I already want it.
And it's by a very, very...
Make me scared of these things again. It's just like if I'm playing Isolation, right?
He did Don't Speak.
Evil Dead.
He did Evil Dead, Don't Breathe, Don't Breathe.
Don't Breathe. Don't Speak is a song by No Doubt.
It's a good one.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah, it's 40.
Yeah, my bad.
The alien knows what you're thinking.
He don't need no reasons.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's I love it.
I'll continue with it. the lyrics, because you know I
don't tell me. I was listening to that actually, probably
drinking in
not
Texas.
Even a week ago. Yeah, drinking
in Texas, crying. Don't speak.
They have a really huge like Korean population there. So they had this one place that was like a Korean Walgreens. What's the other place? The store. Wegmans. It's like a Korean Wegmans. You walk into this store. It's H Mart, bro.
It is H Mart. Okay, cool.
Listen, yes. I walked into this place. There was this joint called Mr. Dumplings, right? And I'm like, oh, I could go for some dumplings. So I got these soup dumplings and I got these pork dumplings, bro.
Yes, please.
I was in heaven. They were the and this lady. I go to the lady. I'm like, hi. I was like, I'll take your king. I was like, I'll take your king. I literally was like, I'll take your king dumplings. She goes, no. You don't want that. You want these soup dumplings. And I'm like, yeah, I want the king dumplings.
She's like, me.
He said, no. You want the soup dumplings. And I was like, I want the soup dumplings.
You want the soup dumplings?
Wow.
I want the soup dumplings.
And I was like, okay, I am so glad I listened to that lady. It was the best decision I ever made in my life. She's like, you have to bite
the best decision she ever made for your life. That's what you're saying.
And they were cheaper than the king dumpling, too.
Trust the expert.
Like, you think she would try to upsell you? No, she just wanted me to have a good taste experience. She's like, you got to bite the top off. And then you pour the soy sauce in there. And I was like,
dang.
What?
So Alien so Romulus.
Yeah. Anyway.
Jesus.
Jesus Christmas.
Alien Romulus. Dumpling was like a candy. Oh,
Speaking of things that'll bite the top off of you. And by the top, I mean your face.
Oh, exactly. So
Go ahead, Michael.
The lead of this is an actress named Isabella Merced.
Is she supposed to be Ripley's daughter?
I don't know. Ripley's daughter's in Isolation, so I doubt it. But
yeah, I know. I just wish it was.
Her name
Why
is
do
Kay,
I know her?
Because she's playing Dina in Last of Us Season 2.
Nice.
And she's also Dora from the Dora Explorer movie that came out, the live action
I knew we talked about her recently.
Yeah, she's playing Dina, yeah. So that's going to be good. A lot of people I've not seen before, which is also great. I like that.
New cast.
New blood for the facehuggers.
This is in between Alien and Aliens.
I thought I read that in an article.
Yeah.
So this isn't a sequel to Covenant?
I thought no. I read
something
it.
Else. Nope. Oh, really?
Might have had a fever dream about it. I don't know.
No. You're right, Dan. I read the same as well too. So it just makes you wonder if they'll build any ties. Obviously, they'll connect it to Will and Yutani. And whether LB-426 gets any mention, we'll see.
This is going to be one of them requels, isn't it? They're going to... It's when they make something new, but fix something they messed up. Like, oh, she's also playing Hawkgirl too. Yeah.
Well, I mean, like Alien is a horror, and then Aliens is action sci-fi, right?
It's
like
both action horror. They were very afraid.
They were afraid, but I was
not chilling.
I was like, game over, man. Yeah. It was good. It was
the audience. But Alien 3 is like they gotta like fix that probably. So I think that's what they're doing here. Like
Alien 3.
I've learned to love it over the years.
That's when you learned that the xenomorph takes the form of like whatever it comes out of, because it was like a dog.
Yes.
The dog was, yeah.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, I mean, so I don't think this is I don't think anyone's related to Ripley. God, I hope not. Like, just make new characters. Please. The only thing we need to see again is the xenomorph and the gun. And we saw that in the trailer. And it looks like it's going to have a little bit of both of action. That's why they were like, this is her with the gun. She's going to be shooting people and being badass at some point in this. But
yeah, the thing that I noticed, though, Michael, is that there's a lot of the. And
face huggers,
they were all like, I like how you made a noise.
I don't like how you made a noise because it like sent a shiver down my spine, and I don't
spider shit.
Well, we can see CGI face huggers do their thing.
They were athletic.
Yeah, they were like,
I was like seeing this, I was like, holy shit.
The hurdle is
tying them up to a sports contract
because Neil Blomkamp,
decathletes, all of them.
I watched the trailer and the first thing I did was slammed on my phone and just go, nope.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, here's the wild part, right?
Right at the beginning, it just like shows the part of the ship and then blood splattered all over a door and just screams. And I was like, yes. I am not a horror guy. That's why I'm probably going to have to watch this with the lights on, not in the movie. I'm going to have to see it in the movie theater, but I'm going to be holding my wife.
Can't wait.
You have to come see this with me. I can't go by myself.
But because Neil Blomkamp was supposed to do that and be like, I'm going to fix 3 and make
I remember that.
Hicks live
that
and,
so awesome.
And Newt live in the crash. And like there was Hicks with like the bandage. He had an eye patch because he lost the eye. It was all this art. And then they were like, no.
And Ridley Scott gave it the old thumbs up. And I read like what he said about it. He was like, like super excited. I know he's been getting a lot of shit.
No, not like that. It's just whenever that they go back, getting a thumbs up ain't hard from these old directors no more, man. Yeah. I'm sorry.
All right. But I mean,
James Cameron has greenlit every Transformer since 3.
You're right.
Let's not jump off the
money.
That's why he came with the thumbs up.
Yeah, I know.
Napoleon but Bob, pay me. Pay me.
Don't be hurt. Gladiator 2 hate on here. Joaquin like that. I know, but it's still like I was reading that article and I was like, I need to see a trailer. That trailer came out and I was just jumping like this. Finally,
it's good to see the xenomorphs again.
Thank you, Chris. I'm with you because I don't know if it.
It's not a good thing.
Well, the mouth inside the mouth.
There's a scene
in this movie that is just next level. So we're about to be scarred for life. I'm sure.
I can't wait to see which one.
And I was already scarred enough.
Well, yeah, that's
from
just
this
it.
Series.
You know, that's just it. The first movie.
It messed you up.
It's childhood trauma.
It's
the body horror aspect of it all, right? Yeah. Like the stuff that's what gets under your skin, and it's hard to forget it. But it makes for good cinema, especially when it involves xenomorphs.
If I have nightmares about something that doesn't even exist, yes. Mm-hmm.
Fuck yeah.
I mean, I don't want the nightmares, but
hell, you do, dude.
And you know it's a good movie.
Yeah, you do. It's good for the heart, dude.
Yeah.
Is it?
Good for the heart. Yeah, man.
It keeps the anxiety levels like up here.
There you go. On your guard.
It don't need to be any higher, but let's see if we can top the bar.
Take uppercut of zombie dreams, apply it to real life. It's fine.
Lucid dreaming. You could fight
there it is.
No, I don't want any of that.
No, it's fine.
The minute you punch them, they bleed. What
None
happens? They bleed on you.
Yeah, they bleed on you. You're just like, my arm. It falls off.
Why am I even here?
Oh, if we don't get some acid blood action.
Oh, I'm sure we will.
Dude, of course
I'm sure we will.
Listen, Dave, they're going to check every box. It's going to be a loader.
Exactly.
Come on, dude. You know how this shit goes. It's going to be a loader scene.
I'm just worried. Like, I hope, like, look, guys, trailers are
cyborg
awesome.
White blood.
We all know what trailers can make us all just so happy
and traumatized.
But then all of a sudden the movie comes out and it's like, what the hell? It took three of the best scenes in the whole film,
and they were in the trailer, and that was it.
Yeah. That's why, you know, when you make five trailers, it's like, oh shit.
But his horror movies were good. They were good, and I feel like they're really going to do this movie justice. I'm just wondering if there's going to be a queen, because we saw a little.
They kind of messed that up when they made a king in one of them other movies. I was like, that's not how this works.
Can't have a king.
What are you talking about?
Up when this part's over.
You're pissing off nature. Stop that.
Well, I'm wondering. Yeah, you have to wonder how this happens. How did they end up with so many of that life form on one ship? That like
they could have found the eggs, brought the eggs on board, and then an alien.
That's right. Like they're on a mission to pick up these eggs to bring back. Right. That's their mission, and
androids.
Whatever happens, happens. Dude. Right. Yeah.
The queen reveal in Aliens. Is so fucking good.
It is.
Oh yeah, it is.
Like the build up of her follow, like she's like, I just duct taped two guns together.
When she's
just would know what the fuck's going on.
Dude, she's got that giant thing just crapping out eggs. Like,
and she looks up.
It's funny. I read what it was called the other day. Now I've forgotten. So,
oh man, I mean, like, that was so good. Get away from her, you bitch.
Yeah. She's like, "Oh, you big as shit! I'll be right back."
Mama she's wearing said, the loader suit, doing the robot.
Strap the fuck. Show you.
Yeah, man.
You gotta love it though. I mean, it just that the whole thing show about aliens too, because you really love Ripley going into it, right? And then she's paired up with these space marines, and you know, just the scene with her. She wanted to prove herself what she can do, and there's because I don't know, is there anything you can do? She gets in the loader and she's like, where do you want it?
You know? Yeah, you can have this claw.
Yeah,
it's so cool. Yeah, but I'm gonna miss Sigourney Weaver, obviously, but at the same time, it's like it's cool to see what they're gonna do with this.
Sigourney Weaver. Renee Zellweger. Rush Limbaugh.
Substitute teacher. Balake.
Balake. Ron Balake.
Me and Chris have been sending each other that shit from this one on Instagram. He does all of that like that bit from Key and Peele. Where they do the basketball players.
I have been
sending each other shit back and forth like
awesome
crazy.
Awesome, Buckshot.
That dude's laugh kills me every time.
He's your 12 washing beard.
Yes. Oh, man. But anyway, yeah. I mean,
Blake Schwinslow.
Jack it Mary's does. Like, Romulus looks good.
Jack Mary's Tech Teratrix is my favorite.
He's so confident. Jack Mary's Tech Teratrix.
They went so nuts where the one dude is like, he was doing like R2-D2 noises as his name. I was what the fuck?
It's all about Hingham and Kringleberry, though.
Yeah. That's to keep moving on to some scariness, I guess we're going to start going into goth dark.
Oh,
is
fuck. Fuck's sake.
Skarsgård in the Crow remake, which we
it's
were all
not
talking
called
about.
That. It's called the Crow. Yeah.
It's called the Crow. I know. I'm just saying,
sir.
Remake.
I'm joking.
But
the Crow.
It didn't have to like. Look, the trailer looked awesome.
The trailer is awesome.
The trailer's awesome.
The trailer is awesome.
It's so good. I was watching it.
That trailer.
The only thing we have to talk shit on is the fact that it shouldn't be a remake. It should just be a Crow story.
Another Crow movie,
But damn, I'll be lying if I said that trailer looked awesome.
It looks good. Yeah.
I mean, didn't look awesome.
It was a little bit triggering considering the very first thing.
What, the bags over the head?
They are.
No, it's literally like very blatant, violent, gory gunshot to the stomach is like the first. Yeah. I was like.
And it's like the thing that like killed Brandon. It's
yeah.
very weird.
And that is what it was. Yeah, and I literally watched it. I went, ooh.
He was doing the rest of the trailer for me, the just table gave me the or ick. Something apparently in that scene, right? Like he was doing some move off the table when he was with all of the gangsters.
It was a shotgun.
Yeah, it was a shotgun blast to the stomach. And that's what happened in the trailer.
And they did that in the trailer, which I didn't love. Can't lie. Made me feel a little icky.
Yeah.
Movie looks good, but that was icky. Wait
till that black
would have been worse if it was Alec Baldwin.
That's true.
All right.
I'm sorry.
We just need Catherine O'Hara to be in it. Bro. Make the crows have eyes.
That's going to be an amazing documentary one day, though.
Yeah, it will.
I like that. Mark, I like that.
But it does look really good. I mean, Skarsgård looks freaking awesome.
He's
great. The dude lifted some weights, got himself toned up looking. I don't know if he's always looked like that, but
no, he's in another film where he had to get big too. So it's just like,
just
it worked out well.
His residuals,
which is this other film that he's in that he's doing it for, looks way better than this.
Cool.
Ooh.
It's called Boy Kills World, and H. John Benjamin is his inner dialogue because he's mute. Thank you.
Wow.
So Bob's Burgers is like talking for him while he does action scenes. So
damn.
I love it.
Here's $15.
Yeah, I'm going to go see it. I mean, I think it'll be a good movie. The story looks awesome. The bad guy. What's his name?
I don't trust the director.
Yeah, we know the story. Apparently, they're just going to be like,
the bad guy in the movie, original movie is 10-10. That was his thug name.
Okay, but like, what's the actor's name?
That was
Michael Wincott. Tintin.
Yeah,
because
Top Dollar.
That's Top Dollar.
I've always liked that dude since 30 Days a Night.
I liked him
when I'm serious. I loved him as the head vampire in 30 Days a Night.
Yeah, he was awesome in Nope.
Oh, he wasn't.
He was
director. Yeah,
but dude, he was great in that movie, and he's a great bad guy. So. Sign me up. I'm going to watch it.
I mean, my only problem is that it's Rupert Sanders, the director. He's not.
Yeah.
What has he done?
He does Snow White and the Huntsman, which is like whatever. And he did the Scarlett Johansson Ghost in the Shell movie. So
it was a whatever movie. God.
You guys have fun with that, I guess.
Yeah.
He did one episode
of Foundation. The visuals will be good.
Yeah, it'll look pretty.
What is he like, another Michael Bay guy where it's just
he hasn't done a lot. He's done those two big movies, and he's done music videos.
Oh shit. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Well, we'll see.
If you're gonna deviate that far from the story, because it just looks like the person who kills Shelly, is that his girlfriend's name?
Yeah, Shelly Webster, yeah.
The person who kills it's not like, you know, this gang coming in to kill her off or yada yada.
No, it's pretty fucked up.
It's something totally different. I'm like, just name it. That's what it's looking like. Don't have an Eric Draven movie. Like
it also looks like he comes back to life in the apartment. Like he doesn't get buried or anything. Like it wasn't.
Yeah, I need like zombie Eric
because he wakes up on the carpet like what?
Yeah,
call him Eric Draven
from.
And then he's like,
from fucking Cyberpunk. That's what he looks like.
And then, like, he has a moment with some like magic man, like some
magic
sorcerer.
Man gives him crow powers thing, which I think is just the crow manifesting itself into a person to talk to him.
Yeah, because I think they've done that.
That's exactly they did that in the.
I didn't need that.
One of the.
I just needed a crow to be like,
he turns into the ASMR episode continues.
I need this to not have this be a remake.
Yeah,
wait, Dan. What's the crow noise? Very good.
Yeah, you're welcome.
For all of you who watched The Traitors season 2, there's a challenge where they had to imitate bird calls, and that brought me right back.
Yeah,
brought me right back. It was hot.
You know, crows are really smart, though.
They're very smart.
They are, and they remember. They don't freaking forget.
Of them being red, and it's pretty good.
Yeah, they're smart. You just got to be nice to them, and they'll bring you presents.
Yeah, I mean, also, this movie has been in development for, like, presents. I don't know, 20 years? They've been trying to remake this fucking movie. So, like, there's literally test shots of Momoa when he was like a child when he auditioned for this.
It's just a shame that they had to remake they remake it. Like,
what's
like
you, space is supposed to play it.
Dracula, it could have just Dracula, been a movie. Old
Luke Evans was supposed to play him at one point.
Crows it's are true. Like, mm-hmm. It's actually a true scientific fact. Crows don't forget a face.
Yeah. Yes,
if Max. You are mean to them and they run into you like a year later, they will remember your face. They will remember. And yeah, it's true. It's They're true. Also called murder.
Actually, huh. Incubus's like fourth album was A Crow Left of the Murder.
All right. So so Dan's Incubus. Back. And
saying so stupid Incubus. Shit.
Yeah. Crows
I happen. Wish. I wish. I wish they were
also,
good again.
There was a pretty big Unreal event that happened where they were showing off Unreal 5.
Segway.
And that's fucking scary. I play a lot of video games. I don't think I'm ready for that shit.
Yo, but, that I mean, like you were saying in the
that
pre-show,
shit's unreal.
It looks too real.
Yeah.
Too it's, real, Roy.
It's too real to be real. It's unreal.
It's have, Unreal Engine 5.
Yeah. It's too real Engine 5. It's so, Uncanny Valley Engine 5.
So they
do you know the gameplay? Like,
we don't know any gameplay yet, but they showed off a cutscene opening thing for Marvel's 1943: The Rise of Hydra, which is a Black Panther and Captain America led Marvel game, set in 1943, obviously, and it's like, you know, Steve Rogers in full, like, World War One, First Avenger-style cap gear with the Black Panther at the time during World War II, which is T'Chanda, who is T'Challa's grandfather, and Nanala, who's his wife, who is the queen of Wakanda. And Gabriel Jones is there, who's, like, been in, like, every Holly Commandos thing ever. So it looks like it's going to be set during, like, it looks like Captain America, the First Avenger vibes, which I'm for it.
I love that movie. It
looks like
so
there's two
cool.
other players, like those, like, yeah. At the end, there's two other players. There's a yeah. soldier and this chick with a sword.
Yeah, the soldier yeah. is Gabriel Jones and the chick with the sword. The
it looks good.
Yeah, it looks awesome.
Also, and it's really cool. This is just me asking if I missed something. They mentioned that, like, I didn't need there to be three super soldiers here.
Right.
Who's the third one?
It could be Red Skull. It could be another made experiment for the game. It could be a brand new, because it's a lot. And like, all we know is that Captain America we thought was Weapon One. That's a whole other story.
Yeah. Is this during the era of like that character Toro that was like the Human Torch?
It would be around that time, yeah.
Right? All right, okay. There's so many yeah. cool little things they could do with this era,
yeah,
right?
Totally. Yeah.
People don't know those characters, and it would be cool to see them in yeah. a game.
So. You also get Nick Fury too, because Nick Fury was from World War.
That's right. Too. And then was it the Howling Commandos? Whatever's that, what they're called?
Yeah, because Gabriel Jones is there from the Howling Commandos.
So there's that.
So there's that. Jeez. I mean, it looks good. It's also Amy Henning. It's her big project. Amy Henning wrote the first three Uncharted, and she also directed the first three Soul Reaver games, so she's great.
Amazing.
Yeah, she's amazing. And this is also Skydance, who's making this game, who's a movie company who's dabbled into video games. And
why not?
They have, this is their first
money.
Game.
Give me.
Skydance New Media. They have this game and a to-be-announced untitled Star Wars game.
Nice.
So they are also on the docket for them making another Star Wars game.
I need Outlaws.
TBA.
I need Outlaws.
Oh, it's coming, brother.
Oh,
I think that's the next big gameplay for that's coming soon, for sure.
Yeah, that's going
to
be
because it's supposed to be like this fall, so I don't see why it won't be like by the summer. But yeah, that looks pretty rad. I've never experienced... We haven't really experienced T'Chanda ever. He's only been mentioned.
Yeah.
And
right.
There was a photo of him there's a panel of him in 1998 run of Black Panther, and he was just T'Chanda back then. He's also his name is Aziri the Wise, and he has a city named after him in Wakanda. So he's like a big deal. Because he's like, you know, T'Chaka's dad, who's like, you know. And his dad, I forgot his name. So he's not the first Black Panther. He's the second Black Panther in the lineage that we know of, at least. And he wasn't given the T apostrophe before his name until very recently in 2021. There was a book just called Wakanda. Mm. And that's where they mentioned him again as T'Chanda. So that has the T'Chanda, T'Chaka, T'Challa. So
is that like a, like, what's the T apostrophe?
It's
like,
just, what's the T with T'Challa? Jesus
Christ. Well, I think exactly it's just because it's like, well, here's my name's T'Challa. I'm gonna name my son T'Chaka, and he just named his son.
Okay, I just wasn't sure if it was like
his dad
like
doesn't have
a Black Panther, like, you know, yeah, thing.
His dad's name, thing. No, because his dad's name was N'Tali with an M, and he was like the first Black Panther.
Okay,
so yeah, but Aziri the Wise is like, that's his monarch name because he like retired the Black Panther, like became like a monarch of Wakanda while there was a king. That's how good he was. So
he's also being played by Kerry Payton. Clearly the more interesting one because it's a different person. We all know fucking Steve Rogers.
Yeah, this is also a different Black Panther. Like, we don't know this guy. We don't know his attitude or his, like, you know.
We all know Steve Rogers. Like,
what the there he is.
Yeah,
frozen in a brick
of Wonder
of Wonder White.
Oh God, awesome!
But yeah, I mean, so that looks really good. I'm excited.
It does. It does look good. I saw it while I was away, and
it's a brand.
I was
new
curious.
Game.
I thought, yeah, when I saw Sundance, I didn't like look into it. And I saw Sundance. Yeah. I was like, did someone just make? Is there a movie coming out made by Unreal? Like, is that what they're doing now?
I mean, dope.
But I put it past it's them. A game, so I'm cool with that.
I mean,
that
because Marvel's trying to branch out outside of Insomniac. So
yeah, why not?
So they're doing that. Bethesda's doing the Blade game. So it's like they got
so
stuff
good.
Going on. Yeah, looks so awesome. Good. Think about the Kill Blade in the comics, though. I'm just calling that now.
Right. What?
But sure. He'll be back in a couple
weeks. Of course, that's the point.
You can't kill the fucking Daywalker, man.
No, you can kill him, and then he'll be back.
Well, he has a series coming, a crossover coming out called Blood Hunt, which is all revolving around him, his Dracula, and her.
Is that movie still coming out by Marvel?
Yeah, of course.
What?
Someone just left again, but yeah.
Yeah.
Someone left like 2 days ago, but it's still happening.
I was hearing some doom rumor, Dr. Doom.
You were hearing some doom doomers?
Some doomers?
I'm just so excited about Dr.
Same
Doom.
Same way, like, buddy.
They have to shift stuff around now that Kang is out of the
guy
picture.
That I was talking to somebody at a party.
No longer called the Kang Dynasty anymore.
And I can't remember who the hell
movie.
He said was going to be Doom.
Well, they were
now
saying,
I'm blanking.
The rumor was Mads still. That's the last thing I heard was Mads.
Mads would be a pretty cool dude.
The same
really
people
cool.
who leaked Pedro, Kirby, and you know.
I just don't want Galen Erso to be a bad guy.
I do.
I mean, it's fine.
Ben Mendelsohn said he can do it. He plays a delicious villain.
Oh wait, no, that's the wrong guy. Am I thinking of the wrong guy? Am I thinking of the right guy?
What are you talking about?
You said Mads, right?
Yeah.
Oh yeah. Never mind. Yeah. Okay, I was thinking the wrong guy.
He cries stuff in movies.
He'd be perfect. Cool thing about him, though. It's like you can care about him as a kind character, and then he can scare the shit out of you. So it's all good.
Not yet, Jerry.
Give me. we have to talk about X-Men 97, too.
Yeah. All right. I was thinking of the other guy. Never mind. But yeah, no, Mads would be great. I mean, my Stardust. I never cried like that before in Star Wars.
But he'll make the Death Star, though.
Yeah.
He did.
Under duress.
Problematic phase.
He added the fucking goddamn
problematic phase.
Thermal exhaust port, bro.
We love a messy bitch.
Oberon and what was the other planet? They got like one exhaust.
Oh, Jedha.
Yeah, Alderaan and Jedha still...
But they still got
I imagine you bring up
they
that guy on those planets. Oh wait, you can't on one of them. That's a bit of a bummer. But
But yeah,
then your argument will crumble.
I forget who it was that my friend was telling me that there was a rumor about Dr. Doom, and I can't remember. I wish I remembered, but it just blanked on me. Whatever. But yeah, Mads would be. I would love Mads.
He'd be cool.
Mads versus Pedro. Like, let's go.
Yes. Yeah, that would be pretty sweet.
Acting mm-hmm. and stuff.
That would be yeah. pretty sweet.
And that would be two superpowers.
Wouldn't it
of
just be
right
awesome
there?
If it was randomly like Nicolas Cage?
That would be so fucking rad.
Oh I my god, what, Nicolas Cage.
There's my fan casting.
Exactly. No, really, it's John Travolta though.
I mean, I know Boop would be like freaking out.
And Ryan Philippe as Dr. Doom.
Oh, jeez.
What the fuck?
So put the bunny back in the box.
Speaking of old stuff that's new again, Marvel X-Men 97 is pretty rad.
I didn't get to watch it yet. So
it's looking good.
And I heard it starts off right.
It's hot, brother.
Right after.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's like Charles Xavier's dead.
God. Damn right. it, I'm excited yeah, to watch hold that, back dude. On that. It's I'm just so like, glad it's out.
This is what's going on. Here you go, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, good job.
Yeah. I love it because, Disney. You know, it's so funny. I've seen pay more buzz more. Around the X-Men this week and I have in a long time, mm-hmm. and this is only the beginning.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so, again, in I all hope the, all of this wins. And the movies lead to Alpha Flight because that's what I've been waiting for years.
Man.
We will see.
I want Alpha Flight to be cool enough to be a movie, too.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I wanted it to be cool enough to be a movie.
Yeah.
That'll be rad. Have Sasquatch and Wendigo and all that shit.
Dude. Oh.
So, has everyone here seen X-Men 97? Or at least the first episode?
I watched both.
No, I haven't seen I mean, I used to watch the old John when I was little, and that's why I'm excited for this.
It's all that and so much more. They did right by the series and everything you've seen before. So
yeah. And the art looks like it lines up too. I mean, better animation, but it looks like the art, like the way everyone looks is good.
Yeah.
Except, everyone was pissed off that they didn't give Jean Grey, what's her face? Rogue. Yeah, they didn't make Rogues sexualized. Like, oh, wow.
Oh, my God.
It was like one frame in that entire show.
And that was by accident.
I was like, are you guys
artists?
Yeah. That's okay because we got Gambit Midriff, so I'm good.
But whatever. I'm just like, what? If you're watching that to go fucking use a bottle of Jergens and tissues,
tell them,
you're watching the wrong shit, bro. Shit. Just
it's
watch it for the
cartoon.
Fun.
It's a cartoon.
Yes, thank you.
All day long.
Oh, my God.
It's cartoon. A cartoon. It's not real people.
Not real people.
It's not real.
Nope.
It's not.
It's no, but that never stopped people who are into yaoi and hentai and all that stuff.
Very true.
I mean, some boys found their sexuality with Rogue.
You don't want to think about that. You don't want to think about it, but it's also not the end of the world. It's like it's kind of embarrassing that folks lose their shit.
Yeah.
Because her booty isn't round enough.
I just, that's
how
exactly
dare they body
drives,
shame her.
That's what drives me nuts. I'm just like, what?
It's so dumb.
I'm watching it for her to like put her hands on somebody and they fucking
no, I'm watching
what's
the
her name
X-Men.
From Space Jam, remember?
Watching.
You know what? She has not been active since the 90s. So what if she's not been hitting the gym as much since the 90s?
Exactly.
The muscle definition's not there anymore.
There's a little less sugar on sugar.
That's right. Let her be.
Well done. Good though, man.
I'm excited.
They made Cyclops badass and
Storm's
the shit. Cool. She fucked some people and it was fucking rad. Whew.
But it's just all these little things from like the era I remember reading in the comic books getting sprinkled throughout, and I almost felt like, oh my god, we're already getting this. Oh my god, it's you know, like I wasn't expecting all that. It was really, really cool because it was taking me back. Well, yeah, that's true.
Are you sure you got that last channel button ready?
I'm so glad you're here, Jerry. That's good. That's a good one. Boys.
Can't get caught. Last chance.
That was a pretty good conversation about that without spoiling it too much for Dan.
Yeah,
so
I'm glad. I'm gonna pop that on.
It's just we're just
tomorrow.
Hyping it up for you so that you'll enjoy it even more.
No, there I'm ready. Go. I'm ready.
With one hand on the remote.
Exactly.
With one hand on the remote. Oh,
I'm sorry,
yeah.
Dude, what?
Oh yeah. Dan, is that a roll of Bounty? This is the quicker picker upper.
It was Charmin extra soft.
Cha cha cha, Charmin.
You don't want it extra soft. You want it extra strong, my friend.
Yeah, dude. Yeah, dude. Pick up the pieces, brother.
Exactly.
Well, anyway.
So,
speaking Furiosa. Yeah, Furiosa trailer looks fire.
Oh,
dude.
Yeah, it looks does. Good. It looks fantastic.
Pun intended.
Yeah, I want to see it.
Yeah
that trailer. I actually didn't get a chance to watch it until today because I was like, oh, that's right. We're going to talk about it. But yeah, I'm in. I'm so in. Yeah, it looks really, really cool.
I mean, yeah, I just love the cinematography, like the way it looks.
Go to win Oscars again.
And this is like a prequel, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that this looks fantastic.
She becomes, and Charlize Theron's like narrating it too.
Yeah.
Oh. She's in it. Like, yeah. So in some fashion. I don't know if it's dialogue from the first movie, from Fury Road, but she's like talking in the trailer. So.
Okay.
My hype for this movie went from near zero to very high.
Yeah, the first trailer was like, eh, but this trailer was like...
Seriously, I saw the first trailer before Dune, okay, in the movie theater, and I was just like, eh.
Yeah, it was all right.
Why didn't you put this one in the movie theaters on the big screen?
I love Anna Taylor-Joy, so there's that. I mean, it's like, put her in something, and I'm going to stop. Oh, there you go. There you go. Okay.
Fucking Jerry. Crank it.
Can I just say something? Are we up by 60 people? Thank you, everyone.
Yeah.
For being here for this.
Thank you for cranking it to Adventure Time and X-Men 97.
That's amazing. Yeah.
Come on, tell your friends.
Trailer does look badass. I'm
sort of bro-wankium.
Speaking of Anna Taylor, she was a bit in Dune 2, which I got to see while I was away.
Dan saw Dune 2.
I know you guys talked about it while I was gone, but it's okay. I just wanted to give my take on it.
Yeah, give me a take, dude.
Bro, I mean, it followed the book, like, pace so perfectly because, like, the first movie, it was building it all up, right? Mm-hmm. And you're just waiting for all the action. And then the second movie was just like, what the fuck just happened? I mean, just... Mm-hmm. I was in, like I was telling you guys, I was in a, the music, the score.
I'm Zimmer, dude.
I was like, holy.
What is that? Balls. Balls. Claire,
it was
Claire.
So good.
Claire, run it back for me.
Chris did a pretty good job.
I was like, my crow noise.
You put your shopping cart back in the fucking.
I was just so happy, dude. I was so happy that the second movie just, it was like
it's very
Dune
good
part
book.
One right here. Dune 2 just bang. And like it's setting us, I mean, Christopher Walken as the Emperor.
Whoa.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Then Muad'Dib.
Wow.
We got the Hawken. And Chris, you do it.
My eyes are sucking in. You're so old.
Chris has one of the best.
You have a good one?
I don't like the Atreides. In all of the spice. Oh, good. Had to get the Harkonnens back.
The Harkonnens.
Get a spice production back up and running.
That he hit the worm in the one place nobody would ever look.
More deep. More deep.
More deep.
I was waiting for during the knife fight for him to go, wow! Stab that guy.
Funniest thing was,
Walken, man.
I literally watched Balls of Fury. I watched Balls of Fury on HBO after I saw Dune, which it was like I was sitting in my hotel room and I'm leaning back on the recliner and I'm watching Balls of Fury. I'm like, this is the same man.
That's the Emperor.
I like how Dan's 3 weeks away was like a Korean horror film. Yeah, he was just like, I sat in, but I watched Balls of Fury. And then I started shadow boxing for 3 hours.
Dan Fogler was awesome. Shut up. Oh, man. Okay. Yeah, but I enjoyed the shit out of that second part. It was really good. I was upset that I couldn't get the popcorn bucket, and I wish I had Mark's shirt to go with it. But I didn't get either of those things, and I was a little upset about it. But whatever. The movie was great. And the seats I had fucking...
Was it like
I don't know if anybody's ever experienced D-Box seats, but
son of a bitch,
dude.
What was the last movie? I forgot what
I'm not thinking if they call it D-Box.
It was a trip.
They are called D-Box.
It was a trip.
They're called D-Box.
Michael.
Michael?
I'm not sending anything called a D-box.
They right? did. They
just
did.
Give me the movie, man. Right?
And bro, I'm telling you, those copters were flying. The seats moving and shit. I almost got sick.
It kind of sounds like a That's Dutch person is insulting you. You D-box.
You D-box, dude. You got sick of the D-box, Dad?
It's like a fucking off-market Xbox. But no, it's a good.
D-box. I tried to watch the D-box.
Oh, boy.
Oh, it's what's that song? Mario Sonic.
D in a box. But no, it was really good. I enjoyed it so much. I'm so happy that I got to watch that movie. Claire.
What's up?
You saw Frozen Empire.
I did.
Am Michael, I the only one? Who else has seen it?
I have not seen
haven't
it.
Seen it.
Michael, you call yourself a Ghostbusters fan?
Dude, I am. And relax. I'm still a Ghostbusters fan because right. I didn't wow. see it right away.
What a fake fan.
Real quick, Claire. Back off. Yeah. All right? I was like, doing stuff.
Yeah, that's all right. We have lives.
Claire, please continue.
Yeah, go ahead, Claire, please.
You're not a fan.
Do you want to hear my really insightful take on this Ghostbusters movie?
Yeah.
Please do tell.
It really fucking slapped. Nice. As them kids would say.
The audience score is very high. So
it is, and as it should be, because literally every single person in this movie, and I mean, we know from the previous Ghostbusters movie, we know the casting, especially, you know, is impeccable. Paul Rudd, Carrie Coon, Finn Wolfhard, A+. I don't remember the actress.
All of those rhymed.
Who plays the young Spangler. But then you get the legacy cast in there, and it's just every second that they're on screen is also just absolute perfection and absolute just like charm and like just star power through the whole thing. And then the new additions, the new people who have cameos and like smaller parts in this movie, like just for the record, there is a thing called the Kumail Nanjiani effect. Any movie with Kumail Nanjiani in it is instantly 50 times funnier, more charming, and better because Kumail showed up and just said words. Yeah. Because everything that Kumail says in this movie, I died. I literally died.
You've got Paul Rudd and Kumail like
in scenes together.
Both it's charming just, and funny.
What is this?
Yeah.
Get somebody go hug that casting person because it's just a fun ride, like from start to finish. Not a moment where I'm like where you're
was it kind of scary too?
Yeah, it was a little spooky.
Yeah, I mean from seeing those trailers, I was like, damn, this one looks kind of dark.
Yeah. Spooky. So
I'm down.
Go see it because it was so much fun.
I'm planning on
seeing
it as soon as possible.
And get a Slimer popcorn.
Is that good enough for you, Dan?
Yeah, you know what? Box checked. I'm good.
All right.
I just, you know.
Do it.
You want it? You see it.
Wow, Michael, you're so upset.
Do it.
Oh, my God.
You know, we'll go see it together.
Okay?
We'll go see
it together. I just forgot. Okay?
I'll go with you.
I looked at my watch, and I was like, it's 8 o'clock. That's it. I missed the bus. I guess I'll wait till Sunday to be like, I wasn't good.
Please don't use this as
it
a collector's
came out this
item.
Week, right?
Please don't exactly. use this as a collector's item.
Claire.
Yeah. Yes.
You saw the picture I put into the chat, right?
What?
The cereal box. Oh, yeah.
Yes.
All that shit. Trust me. It's going to become that.
Oh, the 3PO?
Oh, I'm going to get it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. No.
You got to get it.
I'm going to get it. Dan.
Yeah.
Remember the Obi-Wan Kenobi cereal and Pringles?
I ate it all.
I know.
Mel ate it all too.
It was a little stale.
I have my buy cereal box still. I do as well.
It's like a year later.
Did you open it?
No, it's not open.
He just like went to town on that.
So you ate them like they were chips.
Yeah, it's because we bought like 10 pounds.
No, no.
It's because we bought like 10 pounds of weed.
He put...
I had to finish all of it. We couldn't leave without.
It was California. It was legal.
Yeah.
That's so much
me. We did. It was
sure, like a freaking gremlin.
And yeah. What's the only yeah. thing you could possibly?
I uploaded all of my content from Celebration, and Chris is like, we can't share half of this.
Chris is done. You broke him.
It was so Dan was so like he was so munchified, like you could put ear hooks or whatever you call it, like around him, and be like yeah, you feed a horse.
the feedback.
Damn. You were like a raccoon in a bag of chips.
No milk. It wasn't milk to be seen anywhere. No milk.
He didn't care.
He didn't need it.
Need it.
You wear that metal, Dan, of no milk. No milk.
Wow.
Mouth still dry. I don't care.
Yeah. Oh, it was good stuff. I have the box on top of my refrigerator now. I saved the box.
Nice. Still got it. All mine's still in. I'm afraid to open it now.
Yeah, I can't touch that
thing. I never ate the Pringles.
It's going to come out of that.
It's going to be like, and like,
yeah. Yeah, never ate the Scooby-Doo theme. Still got them. So wait, what were you going on about the box? Is there a new box?
No. Ron put in here. There's a True Blue blue milk. Moo,
sorry.
Yeah, True Blue Moo. Whatever the fuck. Yeah, well, they're doing a blue milk.
Yes. Cereal?
A Star Wars.
But it's not the same as the blue milk that they have at Galaxy's Edge from Understand already. No. Like, correct. It's different, right?
Yeah. It is a vanilla flavored milk dyed blue.
Oh, okay.
So,
Sure your teeth are going to fall out when you drink that mess.
Yeah, right.
Yo, you brush your teeth. Have like a couple boxes of cereal, like a couple bowls of cereal with that blue milk. Oh. Just remember that you ate that, because when it comes out later on, it's going to be like, oh, I'm sick, I'm dying.
Exactly.
Just why is it blue?
It's going to be a blue harvest.
It's going to be a blue harvest.
Oh,
God
shit.
God damn.
Just remember what you ate.
Oh God!
Remember what you purchased and what you got.
Oh my God! Yes, Ronald. My God! No, you don't know how terrified I've been after Beats. Okay, it's like,
oh no!
I'm dying.
You call
their nature's candy, don't you know?
Also, is anybody doing a Star Wars marathon? The theater one in theaters.
And
like every other week,
I have like a family member's 16th birthday the next day, so I'm like super busy, but. I am going that evening to see Empire Strikes Back with the SF Symphony playing the soundtrack. So
it's going
to
be so cool.
I'm going to be celebrating May the 4th a good way.
Chris and I are going to be it's a busy day, Star but it's Wars worth it in the end. Beer.
Yeah. I love it.
Yeah, we've got a I guess like we're past an hour here, and we do have an event coming up. We were at it last year, the Neshaminy Brewing Company, a local good spot beer. Here. They do a May the 4th event. They started it last year. Chris and I were involved. It was pretty cool. Dude, hopefully
we should be there with you guys.
Yeah, it was called Bantha Fodder the last time.
Nice.
I'm hoping they come up with something maybe different. If not, the Bantha Fodder was actually really good. It was a good
box. That's all they're doing, but making one of their things.
Like, do they make a special brew for it?
Like
They made a whole new, it was delicious beer. It was a Bach.
I was just going to say, it's got to be a Bach. Like, that's
the Empire Strikes Bach. They should take that and make one.
There. Exactly. Hit them up now and get your royalties right away.
There's on the Untappd beer app, because you check in your beers. If you get so many dark beers, you get a dark side badge after a while. And it looks like the Imperial symbol, too. So it's just pretty
cool. That's cool.
But yeah, we're going to, so I think we convinced them to let us host like the event where we're going to be on the PA doing trivia, selling merch, like just having a good old time at this event. I'm excited. I wonder if they're bringing that band back. Who were they called?
I don't know. I forget.
They brought a lot of people.
A lot of motherfuckers with them. Yeah.
Yeah, they did. Yeah. And it was just so much fun. The families, it was just a nice family event. They had this whole part set up with people selling merch. Chris and I were doing like trivia.
Like, remember how I had like a bunch of the comics? Like,
you gave half of your stuff away.
Now, this year I got some, because it's on Free Comic Book Day again.
Yeah.
I got a bunch of Star Wars free comic book day books that we'll be bringing with me.
Nice.
Regular Star Wars and a High Republic one. So I'll have
a whole box of the Vader down stuff. I'm bringing them.
Bring it.
Oh, yeah. And they're like, that's turning into a collector's item. So bring it up. Yeah. For the people. But yeah, that's going to be awesome. May the 4th in the Philly area. This is Croydon, Pennsylvania, nice. Neshaminy Brewing Company. So it'll be a good time.
Yeah.
And we'll be streaming live, of course, and we'll be on the microphone annoying the people.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
The fire rises.
Yes, it does.
Gentlemen. Holds the gentlemen.
You can get more of that at the event on May the 4th.
That's right. I thank you all so much for being here. I am so blown away. We're at 60 people. That is amazing. Thank you guys so much for joining us. Love my it. Time
Thank
back.
You for joining us.
Hell yeah. If you want more of this, come back next Sunday. But Michael, where can people find you?
You can find me here every Sunday night, Shooting the Poodoo Live, 9 p.m. EST. You can also find me with Claire. Every Tuesday for BX, that is Watch Your Step. That is a floor_gaming. We are skyrimming. Jawbreaker is walking through Dragonfire to bonk you on the head. Mm-hmm. Come by. There will be pocket beef and fire salts.
And next week, we're catching the dragon.
We're catching
dragons.
Yeah, we're catching one.
You want Claire on foot. You want her saving when she's supposed to.
Yeah.
You want her cracking people over the head with a battle axe. Stephen Hawking. Fire salts.
Pocket beef.
Come on down, man. It's happening. Mm-hmm. It's happening. And
then if you want to get depressed, Mike, tell them what happens on Wednesday. You want to get depressed
Wednesday. We are here. It is happening.
I'm so excited.
Last of Us 2. 2-hour premiere.
Wow.
Oh, we're doing it.
Because you can't. You got to do it all in one go. You got to do it.
I have work Thursday, so let's go. Sick.
All right. 9 p.m. So do 9, you want to do 8. 9 p.m. Dan doesn't have work. So 9 p.m. EST still. Stay tuned for that. It's going to be really sad. Get your wet wipes.
Nice.
And you can find me there on those. So, yeah, stay tuned for that. Should be good. Or sad, depending on how your brain works. But stay tuned for that. I hope Claire can join us for that as well.
I'll have to see. I'm not sure, but I want to.
She'll watch with blinders on.
I'll literally just be sitting there muting myself because I'm just going to be making noises that's going to give stuff away. I'm just be like,
like double fisting wine.
Yeah, I'm going to need it.
Pouring it into your eyes.
Claire? Where can everyone find you besides breaking jaws?
Well, you can find me on the social medias at C-Stribs. Across all of them. You can find me on the Imperial Senate podcast. If you're a patron of the Imperial Senate podcast, it is $1 a month for you to get all of my complete full episode reaction videos. All of the ones for Ahsoka are up. I'm going to be doing it for the Acolyte, too. It's going to be exciting. So if you want to watch a cute little episode with me, you know, join the patrons at Patreon. That's pretty much where you can find me. Just follow me and I'll tell you what I'm doing. So
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Marcus?
You can find me across all the socials. I am El Diablito, of course. And from time to time, you can hear me on Gotham Outsiders chatting DC Comics.
Yes.
Nice. Fuck. Hell yeah. And Chris, welcome back, bro.
Hi, buddy.
You can find me at CRyan75 on the Twix and the Instagrams and all that. Just did an interview with writer Mark Bernardin, who does the Amazing New Comic.
It's good.
Had a good time talking with it. It was pretty dope. Let's see. This week I've got Ethan Sachs coming up. Going to have an interview with
Ethan's
him.
Man.
And a new quick shot this week. We have Obi-Wan Kenobi number 6. I think that's the last one. I think that was 6 episodes. And then we have a High Republic Crash Landing, which is a Danny Jose older one with like his character that's based off of Alyssa Wong. So it's going to be dope. Right. Yep.
Fuck yeah. Yes. All right. You can find me at SteelTarget42 on all the socials. Gaming too when I've got time. I probably should have more nowadays since I'm not working my fingers to the bone. And find me Wednesday. I'll be commentating while Michael tries to destroy my feelings.
He will. I'll try. With,
just the Last of Us 2. I mean, I'm a little happier that I don't have to go through the fear and anguish that I went through last time with holding the sticks, but I'm still pretty sure that I'm going to just be upset and just depressed again. It'll be just like I'm back in Texas. And And you can find me here Sundays with all of you fine folk. Everybody joining us, thank you again. And we will see you guys next week. Bye. May the force be with you.
Always.
Pass it to the Alderaantes.
Yes, indeed. If it's a fast ship.
Fast ship. Never heard of the Millennium Falcon.
Should I have?
It's the ship that made the castle run.